very happy to be here with you, and I see the support in your eyes, and I can feel it, that we can together empower infertile women across Africa through improving access to information, education, and health, and change of mindset and culture. As you see, in some cultures, until now, women who fail to have children, they are suffering mistreatment, discrimination, violence, psychologically and physically, and sometimes pushed to die, to death by suicide or being killed. We have to stop this together. But how? We have to change. We have to encourage people to, first, respect women, whether they have children or not. Women are more than mothers. What if a woman cannot have children? She still can be a productive member in society. She can give. She can be a part of a very helpful, and she can give a lot to her community. But again, it's not only her problem. It's almost 50% of the infertility cases due to male factor, while men, and a lot of here are men, cannot admit that they can be infertile. Infertility is not a stigma or a taboo. Men can discuss this openly and have the approach of a team building for family building, team approach for family building. So we have to encourage men, because it's not related to their manhood. It is completely a condition can be managed technically and with a very, very, very small intervention with medicine. So Merck More Than a Mother here with our stakeholders, policymakers, healthcare providers, community members, all the governmental official and VIPs and media, we will work together to achieve the objectives of Merck More Than a Mother through many angles, because we have to target all the angles to resolve this problem and to change a culture. One of them, helping building advocacy, destigmatizing infertility, especially infertile women, speak about it everywhere, like any other condition, like diabetes, like flu, is normal. And then we also have to improve access to education and information, awareness about infertility. Because if you know that the infertility incidence is very high in Africa, it's almost like 180 million couples are suffering of infertility, which is accounts to one couple every four couples are suffering from infertility. It's a huge number. But 85% of these cases are due to untreated infectious diseases. Hence, prevention is very important. So we can actually raise awareness about prevention, so we can eliminate a very high number of infertility cases in Africa. So untreated infectious diseases due to child marriage, genital mutation, unsafe abortion, unsafe delivery, STDs, all this result, if not treated in the right time, result to infertility. So we raise awareness about this, and also male infertility, and for women who is too late for them, like these cases, a lot of people tell me, what are you gonna do with these women? I mean, all this raising awareness and education and building advocacy for the future. But what about the women who is too late for them to have children or be treated due to age or biological condition? We will empower them. We're not going to let them go. And we tell them, sorry, it is too late for you now. I mean, we are focusing on the future. No, we are going to empower them, because economic empowerment is a social empowerment. We are going to establish for them small businesses so they can be independent and productive member in society, and do not wait for someone to help them and to know that they have purpose, another purpose than being a baby-making machine. So this is our empowering Berna.